Well, you don't see this often. 11 a.m. and it's full here at Headingley. They know that this game is on. Oh, it's hit Ben Stokes hard. That's hit him hard.
The front of his helmet has just demolished the back end of it.
I don't remember a series where so many batsmen are getting hit.
Yes.
Well, there'll be a big cheer. There you go. The first run of the day for England. The inside edge, the skipper's gone just before the second new ball. What a breakthrough for Australia. And with that, is it the Ashes? Beautifully placed. And it runs for four. Well, I think the point following on from what we were saying a second ago is that the opposition are nervous of Stokes the batsman, not Stokes the blocker. Four runs. Lovely stride into the ball from Johnny Bairstow. We've seen very little of that throughout the innings.
That's the Johnny Bairstow the Yorkshire people are used to.
Yes.
Four more. Well, it's certainly creating a buzz around this ground. It's Coliseum-like, I'd say.
Not quite where they want it to go, but it's off the face. It's four, that's all that matters.
Oh, it's a fine stroke. Yorkshire crowd are going to love that from one of their own.
Well, this is good from Bear, so you can see it in his eyes, he's fancying this. He's just got to continue to stay in his bubble. Keep waiting for the right balls to hit.
Well, that's got to be wide. And in fact, it'll be the 50 partnership is up. More to the point, it's come at a pretty quick rate as well. Look at that, off just 58 balls, considering Ben Stokes was 2 off 50 overnight. Bairstow's come out, he's injected some real energy into this. Cracking shot. Into the gap and away for four.
Oh, no, no, but wait. Four, six. Six! Into an ecstatic crowd, nothing more than a flick of Ben Stokes' wrists. Yeah. Good hit. Power sweep from Johnny Bairstow.
Bairstow wants to play this sweep. He's very good at it. He's hit that one extremely hard. Got good balance, his head's over the ball.
Oh, goodness, is there an under edge? Josh Hazlewood! Well, Bairstow is not convinced. That is an immediate review by Bairstow. It's Hazelwood's first ball after lunch.
Well, this one stayed low. It's gone on the inside. It's shaking the heads to English batsmen that are out there.
This is a massive moment.
It's dead silent out there as well.
Did it brush glove on the way past? This will tell us. Oh, no bottom edge. Bairstow right to review. He looked a little nervous though, as if he wasn't entirely sure. Oh, off the edge. Well, it's a chance. Oh, that is out though. No question. That's a huge moment. With the Ashes on the line, this was the partnership England were looking towards. 114 shy, Johnny Bairstow gone.
Well, it's a disappointing shot from Bairstow. If you're an English supporter, it was a bit of a half-hearted shot. And it was there for the cut. The ball wasn't a great delivery by Hazlewood, but Bairstow has to go. What a partnership. He goes for 36. England are now 245 for 5.
Oh, he's taken on the short ball. And to good effect. Oh, how the crowd love that. It takes England past the 250 mark. Oh, now Butler, little slip in the follow through. Oh, no! That is a disaster for Joss Butler and for England. And look what that means for Australia. They've taken a huge stride towards retaining the Ashes now.
Well, you've got a feel for Butler here because he was called through and then Stokes said no. Originally called him through and there's no run there at all.
Well, this innings of Ben Stokes now has just taken on even more importance for England. That's a fine stroke.
I wonder if he'll start playing more strokes here because he's in the position to do it. He's faced 142 balls, seeing the ball well enough.
Hundred to win for England. Stokes on 49, Wokes on one. Nicely played in the gap. 50 for Ben Stokes. What a summer he's having. What an ovation he'll get. 152 balls it's taken him. 3 hours, 32 minutes of batting.
Well played, young man. Look at the crowd. They're up for him. They love him. Isn't it wonderful to play cricket and be a cult figure, loved by the crowd?
Out. Another mistake. And it's that man Hazelwood again. It's a good catch by Wade at extra cover.
Well, congratulations to the bowler, pitching it up. I mean, a man in a catching position. Full credit to him there. Ball straight. Puts people under pressure, but... Yeah, oh, look at this. This is on the up. The man's there. It's saying, oh, catch it. Not great, that, is it?
Four runs. Huge space there, so there's an element of risk if Cummins doesn't get it straight. 89 to win now. Oh, yeah. You won't see a better shot than that. You can watch cricket all year. Lovely from Stokes, takes him to 60. Oh, Jofra's gone for a biggie. He's too short of a biggie, but he'll take it. Oh, Lyon's buying one, is he? Four more! Three to win. And out. Yes, out, out, out. Beautifully judged. Stokes won't be pleased, I don't think. Neither is Archer by the bow of the head. Well, the umpires are going to look. I'm really sure that the fielder's done this well.
Yeah, he's judged this well. Something they practice all teams around the world.
So what they're going to look at here is just to check he wasn't holding the ball as he stepped over the line, but he lobs it back there and steps back inside. South LBW, it is! Broad's reviewing it. He must have hit it. That's the only thing I can think. Were there two noises? Ultra edge. And the umpire's clearly decided he hasn't hit it. And it's hitting off stump. Australia closing on victory here at Headingley.
Catch!
Big shout of catch it and a big mow down the ground. And a six. Tossed out wide by a line. He's put everything into this. Ben Stokes. And over it goes.
It's fun, isn't it? Might not knock off 56 more to win, but it's fun while it's going on.
Oh, what a shot this is. Oh, my word.
Great shot. What a fantastic bit of entertainment this is.
Can he possibly do it single-handedly? The quick single, and he's home. The noise is deafening. It's all for that man. That cleat has got to keep this one out. And he does. More Ben Stokes for next over. And don't the crowd appreciate it?
Pat Cummins is brought back into the attack instead of Nathan Lyon. And now Stokes wants two. Has he found the gap? This is taking us back to the World Cup final and the way he played that situation. It really is something. It's game awareness. Well, actually, cricketing intelligence. That's what it is. He's done it. Incredible. Wait for this signal.
Well, this guy is a freak.
Bangs it in, and Leach is tucked in behind it, resolute, as he was at Lord's against the Irish, so he now defies the Aussies. Giving it a big hit, hard hit, boundary hit, 100 for Ben Stokes. An all-timer, an innings for the ages, an innings that keeps the Ashes alive.
When you have Jeffrey Boycott behind you in the commentary box clapping, you know you've played well.
A six! Oh, Ben, what are you doing to this cricket match? 27 for England to win it. Could it be? It couldn't, could it? He's got again, he's got again! You beauty. Oh, wait a minute, is this catchable? It is catchable. It's dropped. Very difficult. Marcus Harris, the man, sprinting at the ball and throwing himself forward. Takes me back to Simon Jones at Edgbaston. Fine shot, and it's a... Oh, it's a boundary. Oh, is it? It is. It's another boundary. Thunders it back down the ground for four, I think. Yes, it is. This is incredible.
Keep your cool, Ben. 9 to win. You're on the brink of greatness. If you aren't already there...
If Leach survives this ball. That's missing leg stump. Pitching outside leg stump. Survive it he does. Stokes will have his moment.
Well, they have a review left. And will they go for it just as a bit of desperation? Well, they do.
You'll see it pitch outside leg stump. Probably not going on to hit the stumps.
I don't think a 14-ball naught, not out, has ever meant so much.
Catch!
There's a man back! It's six! Ben Stokes has hit it for six! Two are needed to win the Test match, one to tie the scores. Incredible. And he's picked out a fielder again. Oh, no, there's a run out. No way! Oh! Dropped it! Oh, Nathan Lyon has dropped it! It's too much for everybody. It's as simple as that. It's too much.
Well, has he dropped the Ashes? Has he dropped the Ashes? That's as easy a run out as you will ever get. And all this is pressure.
Australia don't have a review left.
Well. Is this going down the leg side, or has Joel Wilson made one of the bravest decisions of all time? Well, here we go. Impact in line, pitching in line, would have been out. Joel Wilson.
It's body. Here's the single. Yes, England have tied the match. England have tied the match. And Stokes has the strike.
Jack Leach, you are my hero. The greatest one of all time.
Here we go then, the scores are level. Yes! For Headingley, 1981. Reid Headingley, 2019. One of, if not the greatest, Test match innings ever played has just seen England a victory in the highest run chase in their history. Having played the first Test match way back in 1877, England triumph here against the odds. A last wicket partnership that we'll never forget. 76 runs in it, of which Jack Leach made just a single. Ben Stokes is the hero of the land.
What a remarkable cricketer. Tim Payne's just consoled Nathan Lyon at backward point. The LBW, the run-out chance. But don't take anything away from that chap. Jack Leach also. What an atmosphere, what a series we have.
We've done so much for the game of cricket here today. As Test matches are threatened by all around them, so even that Australian will wake up tomorrow and surely understand that what Stokes has achieved is so special, so unique. It can inspire every young person in the country. And on the back of that image comes that card. Ben Stokes, unbeaten with 135 from 219 balls. And remember how long he took himself to settle before he truly exploded. Set up by Root and Denley, backed up by Best, Omid Archer. And we'll never forget the best unbeaten single ever made by Jack Leach. There are the Australian bowlers, all of them threw their heart at England, but it didn't prove to be enough. One for Cummins, one for Pattinson, two for Lyon, and four for Hazelwood, who had a fine match and will be disbelieving that he's not on the winning side. 179 and 246 for the Australians. England, 67, I repeat, 67, and 362 for nine, winning the Test match by one wicket. Remarkable. And as we've mentioned already, the highest run chase ever by England to win a Test match, going one better than Melbourne way back 1928 and Mark Butcher's famous 100 here in 2001. An extraordinary performance in every way.